tayo sa Cagayan de Oro City. Lumayo-layo tayo, Mindanao muna. Eto, may mga problema din dito, marami. Via Zoom, si Congressman Rufus Rodriguez, 2nd District ng Cagayan de Oro City. Congressman, magandang umaga po. Salamat po.
Ayong buntag, kabayan. Enjoys. Good morning.
Ay, kamusta po dyan sa Cagayan de Oro? Yung bang problema ng ilang mga mayors at mga local officials ay nangyayari din sa Cagayan de Oro ang kawalan ng bakuna?
Yes, Cagayan de Oro has experienced a big spike percentage-wise of COVID-19 positives.
Uh-huh.
Since May 1, there has been a spike. That's why on May 8, the UP OCTA already reported that Cagayan de Oro is one of the areas of concern, number one on their list at the time, because of the 75% increase. And because of that, I wrote a letter, two letters to IATF Chair Duque and Carlo Nograles. And then, sometime in the middle of May 18, there also was another report of OCTA, again expressing its concern that Cagayan de Oro has a high incidence. And so I wrote another letter this time on the May 20 to Secretary Duque, Secretary Nograles, and the vaccine czar. Nobody answered my letters.
Huh?
That is the problem.
Wow. Oh.
Nobody ever answered. The three of them did not answer my letters. And so what happened? People are dying in Cagayan de Oro City. As of May 1 up to the present, more than 3,400 have already caught COVID-19 positive. And there are many deaths already. You know, if there are more vaccines given to Cagayan de Oro, then we can prevent deaths, because if you are vaccinated, mm-hmm. it is scientific fact that you cannot have a severe COVID-19, mild, and it can be cured. But there is no additional allocation for Cagayan de Oro. The same with Mindanao. Mindanao is a battleground. Matagal na. Sinabi yan, a battleground area, including Visayas. Eh, wala eh. They're taking this sweet time into just giving to Metro Manila, NCR, eh, nagplato na dito, bumaba na nga sa NCR eh. So, dito sa Mindanao, wala. Walang additional vaccine sa kabayan.
Pero ang kung pakikinggan ninyo ang mga statement ni testing SAR Vince Dizon, sabi niya, sinimula nang ipamahagi, ipamigay sa mga lokal na pamahalan ang mahigit sa 2 milyong doses ng Pfizer vaccines. Yung nga lamang po ang reklamo ay walang hiringgiliang kasama. At 1 milyong doses ng Sinovac ang dumating din noong Huwebes. Ang problema po, hindi maipamigay dahil wala pa yung certificate of analysis. Baka kaya hindi kayo masagot ng mga taga-IATF.
Mayroon na kaming analysis. Marami na. Okay. Is it not a big analysis that people die already? My goodness.
Yes.
I have no problem with that. There'll be more doses. But my concern is prioritization to certain areas which are having a spike.
Yeah.
Hindi naman pwede. Business as usual. Yung regular na allocation, ibigay natin. Kung ganong regular, eh ganong parang mangyari. NCR pa lang palagi ang marami. So yan, kabayan ang situation. There is no plan of the IATF and the vaccine czar to look into specific areas which should be given more in allocation because of the spike. Yan ang problema sa Cagayan de Oro. Wala pang na-receive additional vaccine in spite the fact that 1.5 months na ang spike dito. So that is the problem, kabayan.
Hindi lang ho Cagayan de Oro City, including the whole of Mindanao, ganun ba nangyayari?
Including the whole of Mindanao, that is why na MECQ pa rin. Cagayan de Oro, Butuan, Dafor, Sambuangas, MECQ pa rin, Davao. Because, yun nga eh, ang nangyari talaga, is really high incidence are high. People, puno na ang aming Northern Mindanao Medical Center, full capacity na. That is the regional hospital based in Cagayan de Oro. Our private hospitals, you have to have a wait list up to 20. Naghihintay ka every day. You cannot be admitted. That is why the incidence is very, very clear. But why is it that the IATF, Secretary Duque, Secretary Nograles, Secretary Valdez, do not care at all to Mindanao and the Visayas?
Apo.
Eh wala, walang concentration eh. Apo. Kaya nga walang prioritization. Yan ang nangyayari. Maraming namamatay sa Visayas and Mindanao. Yun ang situation.
Apo. Congressman, nababanggit po ni Secretary Galvez na pagdating po sa deployment ng bakuna, tinitingnan din daw po nila yung kapasidad ng LGU kung meron silang cold storage facilities enough to store itong mga vaccines na to. Ang Cagayan de Oro, meron po ba tayo na sapat po na cold storage facilities to handle vaccines?
Yes, those that were sent have been received. and then delivered well by our local government. It is continuing, kaya lang, very limited. We have the cold storage facilities. There is no problem with that. The problem is the inaction of Secretary Duque, Secretary Nograles, and Secretary Galvez. No action at all for the battleground places of the Philippines. Only Metro Manila lang. Yun lang talaga ang nangyayari. So that is why we have a difficulty now in our city because kulang talaga ang vaccine. Nasa A2A3 pa kami.
Nabanggit niyo rin po kanina yung problema naman po sa mga ospital. Ano po ang sitwasyon natin dyan?
Yes, puno na. Our hospitals are in full capacity. And so therefore, we are trying to use already, the city government is using already some quarantine area na doon na, hindi na sa hospital papasok ang mga nakasakit ng COVID kasi puno na eh. So that is a situation that we have. And that is why we are saying na talagang the way to really lessen deaths is to be able for the IATF and Galvez to realize that there are certain cities and places in our country which have higher incidence than the others. So therefore, diyan dapat reallocate and give more priority and give additional vaccines. That is the answer to that.
Opo. Eh, kayo po ba, agree po kayo na MECQ po ang quarantine classification natin dyan sa inyong lugar?
Yes, we agree. We agree that MECQ, Cagayan de Oro, the Force of Buanga, Butuan, and the others, Davao. Yes, because yun nga eh, high incidence eh. So therefore, if it is high incidence, as found by UP OCTA, we have to really have the social distancing, prevention of transportation to 100% capacity, closure of our recreational areas. We agree with that completely. We agree with that. The only problem is we can do so much, okay? We'll follow all the rules. We'll follow hand washing. We follow face mask, face shield. Walang vaccines.
Wala, okay. Palagay ko po, kung aasahan natin, ang sinasabi ho ni Secretary Galvez, yung mga dumarating na bakuna ay ipa-priority ang mga high incident ng COVID-19. But kayo ay high incident sa Mindanao, the whole of Mindanao. At ang panawagan,
yes.
Oo, pero dapat, yung palang dumarating, dapat sa inyo mapunta. Ay meron, kailan nung pinakahuling dumating na bakuna dyan?
Well, of course, we have last week and a few days ago, pero yun ang normal supply of vaccine to places in Mindanao. It cannot be a normal supply anymore because Mindanao is a battleground now, so many provinces and cities,
yes.
Very high incidence. So therefore, kailangan talaga yung bagong bakuna na ma-receive, i-deploy naman sa mga places, not only Mindanao, Visayas, you just talk to Iloilo. So ganun, bakulod. Yun lang ganun, unahin natin yung mga grabe na situation. Otherwise, we'll not solve the problem. There will be more deaths.
Dalhin sa inyo yung... Ang problema ngayon ng DOH, ayon kay Undersecretary Vergere, mahigit o more than 2 million doses ng AstraZeneca ay dapat itong maibakuna na bago mag-expire sa katapusan ng June and July.
Yes. Yeah, so what's the problem? The problem is that they should now be deployed,
correct,
itong AstraZeneca, yung mga cities that really need them to prevent more deaths. Yun ang mangyari. Dapat yun talaga. Eh walang prioritization ng IATF at si Galvez. Wala. They have no prioritization. Business as usual. Yung yung para dito, yung regular na mga deployment, yun pa rin. So that is the problem that we have. And then we have written to him, no answer. Our mayor wrote to him for more vaccines, no answer. So yun ang problema. Government functionaries are not listening even to the leaders of the communities because I don't know anong nila anong strategy nila. Meantime, people from Mindanao are dying.
Congressman, yung mga private hospitals ba sa inyo dyan sa Cagayan ay nagkakaproblema din sa utang ng PhilHealth?
I am sure. Yes, I have talked to some. Yes, PhilHealth has been very much delayed in paying. But in spite of that, our hospital owners in Cagayan de Oro feel for their people. And that is why they are accepting them and maximizing, increase already the capacity for more COVID beds. But then, as I have said, my waiting list, my sister has a waiting list. My family friends, waiting list sila because they cannot be accepted because puno na talaga ang beds. So that is the situation. But the city government is trying its best to have another quarantine area where although you cannot go to the hospital, you'll be taken care of in some quarantine areas. So yun. So that is situation. I believe, yes, they have been, they are also, they have not been fully paid of what they have done because marami ito, ang expenses sa COVID, field health dapat. Pag severe yan, that is the amount. Pag mild, ito rin ang babayaran for COVID cases sa Cagayan.
Congressman, sana nakarating ho sa IATF ang inyong panawagan and we will follow up dyan kay Secretary Galvez at kay Secretary Nogales. Thank you very much po, Congressman. Maraming salamat po. Good morning.
Salamat. Thank you very much for inviting me and us in Mindanao bringing out our grave concerns of the inaction of national officials like Secretary Galvez, Secretary Nograles, and Secretary Duque. Ayan talaga ang nangyayari. Thank you very much, Kabayan and George.
Ingat po, ingat po. Via Zoom, si Congressman Rufus Rodriguez, 2nd District ng Cagayan de Oro City.